This will just be a quick summary of the equations that you're going to need to do your mastering physics assignment for chapter 24. So this first definition of capacitance, obviously, is very important. Charge divided by voltage. Remember, the actual value of the capacitance depends on the geometry of the capacitor, not on the charge or voltage that it's connected to. I've done a number of videos of before and after scenarios of taking capacitors, charging them up, and then connecting them together. You should definitely look at those. You'll need them for your assignment. In particular, the parallel plate capacitor, the formula epsilon naught A over D. Once again, notice that it depends on the material between the plates. So if it's air, you use epsilon naught. If it's a dielectric, you use kappa epsilon naught. A being the area of the plates, D being the separation. If you have a really small separation, you have a big capacitance. The formulae for the equivalent capacitance, if you're in electronics, obviously you've done lots of this, and if you're in mech, then you will have done this just recently in a course. So I think there's just one question where you need to calculate the total capacitance of parallel plate capacitors in either series or parallel. So these are the two formulae that you need. Those are pretty straightforward. Now the energy associated with the electric field between a parallel plate capacitor obviously does depend on the charge that's on the plates, because that determines the electric field. And you can use any of these formulae. Now, if you look at these formula and you say, is the potential energy proportional to capacitance or inversely proportional to capacitance? So you might ask, well, this first formula here implies inversely, which means big capacitors have a small amount of potential energy. But if you look at this second relationship, it seems to imply that the potential energy is proportional to the capacitance, which means a big capacitor has more potential energy. So what's going on here? These seem to contradict each other. Well, what's going on is you have to be very careful about drawing conclusions about proportionalities without looking at what else is in the equation. So if you're going to look at this and you're going to conclude that potential energy is inversely proportional to capacitance, you must state that's only true if charge is constant, if Q equals a constant. Now, the way that you have Q constant is if you hook up capacitors in series, because then they're going to have plus Q, minus Q, plus Q, minus Q. They have the same charge. So if these have two different capacitances, C1 and C2, then you can conclude that the potential energy is inversely proportional. In other words, a small capacitor is going to have more energy than a big capacitor in this situation. Whereas over here, if you're going to use this proportional relationship, you must say this is only if voltage is constant. You can't pull out this voltage and say that we have a proportionality unless voltage is constant. And that would be if they are in parallel. So if you connect two capacitors like that to a battery, they will not have the same charge in general, C1 and C2, but they will have the same voltage. And so in this case, the bigger capacitor will have more potential energy. So that goes together and this goes together. So they do not contradict each other. It just all depends on how you hook them up. Okay, another formula on your formula sheet is this U. This stands for energy density. That's joules per cubic meter. And this just depends on the electric field in the volume of space between the plates. Now it doesn't have to be, they don't have to be parallel plates. They could be some other kind of capacitor, but the volume, this volume in here, this would be the energy per volume. And that's purely associated with that electric field in there. And then the dielectrics, C is kappa, C naught, where kappa is a dielectric constant. So I did a video all about what happens to voltage, charge, energy, electric field when you put a dielectric inside a capacitor. So you definitely should look at that video as well. So that's it for the chapter 24 equations.